This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let's start about the superextremity of the bone, that is scapula. Are you listening? Are you listening to me? Listening to me, the sound is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. Let's start about the scapula. You have the book. You must follow the Vishram Singh and Dabto as well. Hello. Okay. Then, hello everyone. We will start the scapula. This is the left side is scapula. This is the left side is scapula. The anatomical position of this scapula is just like you hold a gun at first, and then it lies to the just left lateral, because this lateral cavity lies left and lateral. Okay. Okay. It is a flat bone. And it is also called the shoulder blade. Okay, this is a triangular bone, triangular in shape. So let's see the external features and surface and borders. Okay, it has three borders, that is superior border, this is lateral border, this is medial border. It has three angle, this is lateral angle. At first you hold it in anatomical position, then you will know that which is lateral and which is medial. Glenoid cavity, as I said before, that it lies laterally. So this is lateral angle, this is inferior angle, and this is superior angle. And already I have said that it has three borders, superior border, lateral border, and medial. It has two surfaces, there is costal surface, and this is dorsal surface. This is costal, and this is dorsal surface. Okay? It has three processes. One is spinous process, as you see behind. This is the spinous process, and this is coracoid process, and this is acromial process. This coracoid process is bird wing, that is crow's lip like. Okay, just or lies this. This is a finger, bending finger. The bending finger, how? This is the vertical and horizontal. So this is vertical and horizontal. Okay, this is known as glenoid cavity. Okay, let's we start about the muscle attachment. You have already known that the red color indicate origin of the muscle, and the blue color indicate the insertion of the muscles. So let's we start with costal surface. The costal surface, there is a shallow depression. This shallow depression gives attach of the subscapularis muscle. Okay. Just hold on. I just follow the page number of Vishram and BD. Okay. Thank you. Okay, this coastal surface, there is a shallow depression, is also known as fossa. What fossa? That is subscapular fossa, and gives origin of subscapularis muscle.
Muscle.
Okay. Then in this border, that is along the medial border of the coastal surface, there is which muscle? That is serratus anterior muscle. Which muscle? Serratus anterior muscle. And how many digit? There is 2 to 8 digit of serratus anterior muscle attached here. There is the insertion. Okay. And see, there is 3 to 4 ridges that running from medial to lateral. See, oblique ridges. These are the ridge. This ridge provide intramuscular septa. Okay. Of the subscapularis muscle. So that means it is a subscapularis muscle is a what? It is multipinnate muscle. See, here is oblique ridge. You will see that. Okay. Okay. From this side, there is the dorsal surface. This is dorsal surface. Just hold like this. This is coastal and this is dorsal. So you see that this is spine divide the surface in two half. That is two fossa. That is supraspinous fossa, infraspinous fossa. So supraspinous fossa give which muscle? That is supraspinatus muscle. This then infraspinatus muscle give origin. That is red in color means it is origin. Okay. Then lies here a notch. Which notch? That is spinoglenoidal notch. And there is also notch. There is also a notch. Here is also a notch. That is superior border of this scapula. Supraspinous. Or that is this is suprascapular notch. Superior surface of the scapula, there is a notch. That is suprascapular notch, and also there is a notch. That is supraglenoidal notch. Okay. Okay, let's come in the which border? This is lateral border. This is what? This is lateral border. This thick lateral border give origin which is muscle. Already you have seen that this dorsal surface. This is glenoid clavity. There is infraglenoid tubercle. Infraglenoid tubercle is T. So that means this lateral has T, so this border has all T. The long head of triceps muscle, then there is teres minor, then there is teres major. Sorry, this teres major is above than teres minor. Teres major always in above, okay? In between two teres major, there is circumflex branch of scapular artery. That give blood supply to these muscles. There is a notch. You will feel a notch here, not here. That is here. There is teres major. Two between major. There is a artery, which is circumflex scapular artery. And come on this spinous process. Okay, this spinous process. It is which border? You see, just hold it in anatomical position. This bone is very difficult, I know. But already we have said that this is the what border? Which surface and which border? This is the lateral surface. So have you seen that all of you? Okay, come to this point. There is a spinous process, and the spinous process have the just see your BD book also. Here is which muscle? Trapezius and deltoid muscle. The trapezius is the insertion of the muscle. The trapezius where the upper border of the crest of the spine on the medial border of the acromion. So where the trapezius muscle lies, like this. This is the crest. This is the medial border, and that was the lateral border. This is the medial border, and this is the lateral border. This whole is lateral border with acromiosus and the spine including. There is a crest. So this is the trapezius muscle. Then this is the insertion and origin of the deltoid muscle. So that's all. Then we will say about the dorsal surface. This angle, this surface, this border. This border, what? This is the medial border. This is the lateral border, and this is the medial border. Always you remember that is the lateral border has T. So that is all the muscle, including the long head of triceps, then teres major, then teres minor. Then medial border all is M, that is rhomboidus. Rhomboidus major, this crest has the insertion of, and all the insertion here. Insertion rhomboidus major, then rhomboidus minor, then rhomboidus major. Rhomboidus minor, then rhomboidus major. And the inferior angle give insertion of the latissimus dorsi muscle. And then again, on this above part of the superior angle, there is levator scapulae. There is levator scapulae. Levator scapulae, rhomboidus minor, rhomboidus major. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is the video clear or not? Please tell me, like. Because
no,
I have started the class with this. It is a very new for me. Have you listening? Follow me.
Yes, ma'am.
হ্যাঁ শোনা যাচ্ছে কিন্তু দেখা যাইতেছে না
দেখা যাচ্ছে না কেন বলো ভাই কোনটা দেখতে পাচ্ছ না বলছ দেখতে পাচ্ছ না
আমি স্ক্রিন দেখা যাচ্ছে আপনাকে দেখা যাচ্ছে
অনেক প্রবলেম
হয় আমাকে দেখতে পাবো না ইউজ নেটওয়ার্ক ধরে আমাকে তো ঠিকই
করতে না মানে বোনস তো দেখতে পাচ্ছি না
ম্যাডাম বোনস কিছু দেখতে পাচ্ছি না জি না ম্যাডাম
আমি তো ক্যামেরাতে দেখছি দেখা যাচ্ছে আচ্ছা আগে ওরা বলতেছে এখানে অফিসে কোনো প্রবলেম নাই ওকে ঠিক আছে তাহলে তোমরা দেখো অলরেডি এখানে বলেছি ঠিক আছে দেখো তাহলে কি আমি বললাম প্রথমে সারফেস এন্ড বর্ডার দেন মাসল অ্যাটাচমেন্ট এটা পোস্টাল সারফেস দেন দিস ইজ ডর্সাল সারফেস ডর্সাল সারফেসে অলওয়েজ এক সাইড হচ্ছে কি আমার দেয়ার ইজ ওয়ান সাইড ইজ অরিজিন এন্ড অ্যানাদার সাইড দি মিডিয়াল বর্ডার ইজ ইনসার্শন দেন স্পাইনাস প্রসেস হ্যাজ lateral border and medial border. Medial border give insertion of the trapezius muscle, and this lateral border give origin of the deltoid muscle. Okay, fine. Now show the superior border. There is a notch. I have already said about the notch. That is suprascapular notch. How there is this? This is the most important for viva. This is most important for viva. This notch. This notch is made in foramen by ligament. Which ligament? Do you know that? Already you have said. Yeah.
Supraspinatus ligament. Supraspinatus ligament.
Suprascapular ligament. Suprascapular knot. Suprascapular ligament. There is same as name as the name. There is a suprascapular knot, suprascapular ligament, and below this ligament, so this ligament formed this knot in a foramen. Foramen হয়ে যাওয়ার পরে কি হবে? There is nerve passing through it. Which nerve? Suprascapular nerve. And above the ligament pass suprascapular vessels. Okay? Then come. There is also a origin of the muscle, that is inferior belly of omohyoid muscle. Already you have seen this side. Okay? Then again come to the processes. This is the most difficult part. One is acromion process, another is coracoid process. If I hold it in anatomical position, this is coracoid process, this is acromion process. Okay. Okay. Come to the point of glenoid cavity. This is, which one is glenoid cavity? This one is glenoid cavity. The upper part is narrow and lower part is broad, which is covered with, this glenoid cavity is covered with what? Glenoidal labrum. This is a fibrocartilaginous rim. Okay. And there is a tubercle, that is supraglenoidal tubercle, and has infraglenoidal tubercle. This supraglenoidal tubercle give origin of the long head of biceps brachii, and there is a cartilaginous ring. I have already said, and the capsular attachment of this glenoidal labrum, that is, you have said, you have seen that this made joint with each bone, that is humerus, shoulder joint. Okay, so this fibrous capsule form the shoulder joint, and it covered the supraglenoid tubercle. So this muscle of long head of biceps brachii muscle is intracapsular. Okay, and others are extracapsular. This is the main point of for fiber. Okay. Now, the anatomical position is always, it is directed upward, forward, and lateral. This is the main direction, upward, forward, and lateral. Okay. This is the anterior part of the neck of the scapula. This full constricted part, this constricted part is this anatomical name. Okay. And this is spine, and like this, just this knot, this goes to the which? Surgical neck of the scapula, this one. This one. Just around this. You have to show this surgical and anatomical neck in your viva board. This is the anatomical neck, this constricted part, and then there is the surgical neck. Okay. Okay, we have already started about the spinous process. Then start with the acromial and foracoid process. This is the acromion process. This one is the lateral border of the acromion process, and this is medial border. This is the under surface, and this is superior surface. Okay. There is a facet. There is a facet. You have seen that there is a facet. You have seen the bones clearly. There is a facet. Facet for what? Which bone? For clavicle. Attachment for acromioclavicular joint. And there is also presence of acromioclavicular ligament here. Okay. So there is which border? There is lateral, medial, and this tip, facet, upper surface, and under surface.
চলে গেল হঠাৎ
Sorry, there is a technical problem. Camera. Okay. Hello. Hello. Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, there is a technical problem. Come to the point. Is that the acromion process? This acromion process there is a facet, and there is a capsular attachment for what? Capsular attachment for there is a facet.
Clavicle.
Now see that facet. This facet gives capsular attachment for the clavicle. So there is a capsular ligament. Which ligament? That is coracoacromial ligament. Acromioclavicular ligament. Okay. Then coracoacromial ligament lies here. Okay. This acromion process here. Just lies the tip of acromion process. There is also presence of coracoacromial. Okay. Now come to the point of coracoid process. What is coracoid process? I have already said. You have seen the bone. Now. This is anatomical position. Very disturbing. This is anatomical position. Okay. So I have already said about the coracoid process. The coracoid process is like what? Is like a bending finger or bird's leaf, like crow, bird, or any bird. Okay. So there is a horizontal and vertical in shape, just like this. Here presence of just attachment of what? This is tip. This is also superior surface. Then which border? This one is medial or lateral. There is a pectoralis minor muscle on the medial border. There is pectoralis minor muscle. Where is the pectoralis minor muscle? Like just on the tip, there is which muscle? There coracobrachialis and shorted of biceps brachii. The tip of the coracoid process is coracobrachialis origin, deep origin of the muscle of coracobrachialis and shorted of biceps brachii on the medial border. This one is medial border and this one is lateral border. So medial border has the insertion of the pectoralis minor muscle. Yes, the superior surface of the medial. Then there is three ligament. Okay. As which bone are attached with this scapula? At first, the clavicle. Okay. So there is a ligament for acromioclavicular, also have the coracoclavicular ligament. See here. Then which bone? Humerus. They are attached with the humerus. So there is in inferior surface, there is on the root of the, this is the root of the coracoid process, the ligament of coracohumeral ligament. There is coracohumeral ligament attached with the humerus. Then also acromial ligament present. Three ligaments are present here. So all about this scapula bone. Hello, you have any question of this? Then we start about the ossification of the scapula bone. How many ossification center? Total 8 ossification center. One is primary and another are secondary. So primary, I'm not sure that is you have here clearly or not. Primary ossification center appear during 8 weeks of intrauterine life. During 8 weeks of intrauterine life. And it appeared near the glenoid cavity. It appeared near the where? Near the glenoid cavity, just like here. You have seen the ossification of the scapula from Biri Chaurasia of 13th page. The figure number 2.11. just go through it, the appear of ossification centers, that is primary ossification center in the Leonard cavity during the 8 weeks of development. Okay, near the Leonard cavity, and others are appeared on different side, two on this acromion process, two on this acromion process, and the lower part of the glenoid cavity, then coracoid process, at first coracoid process, these are the all secondary, okay? Then supraglenoid centers, this one, then inferior angle, which border? The medial border, okay? The secondary centers. Total 8 centers. Okay, the clinical anatomy, you have already known that meaning of scapula. Which muscle is attached here? Anyone say that? There is serratus anterior muscle. So there is paralysis of the serratus anterior muscle causes what? Meaning of scapula. What is meaning of scapula? That is medial border of the bone become unduly prominent, that the arm could not abducted beyond the 90 degree. You have already seen the clinical anatomy, so there is paralysis of the serratus anterior muscle causes what? Meaning of scapula. Okay, all about this is scapula bone. Now, anyone have any question of this from this lecture? Hello. Anyone of you have any question of this? Okay, I will end my lecture then. And you have already seen or told about your item. So next class on Saturday is item number 1 and item number 5. Okay. So till then, Allah Hafiz. Stay home and stay safe. You have any question, students?
I don't know.
Is there any? Hello, are you listening to me?
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Karo kono question ache?
No, ma'am. Hello. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you see the picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you seen me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so there is costal fascia and subscapular fossa. There is subscapular muscle on the medial border. There is serratus anterior muscle. Then on the dorsal surface, there is two border. There is lateral border and another is medial border. This lateral border, deep. Lateral always says lateral T. There is T. So there is inferior the glenoid cavity. There is an infraglenoid tubercle. So there is long head of triceps, brachii, then teres minor, then teres major. Okay. there is teres minor and teres major, then latissimus dorsalis. Then again on the medial border there is rhomboidus major, then rhomboidus minor and levator scapulae. And spine divides the dorsal surface into two half, that is supra spinous space and infraspinous. So supra spinous, that is supraspinatus muscle and infraspinatus muscle. Okay, and then there is on the superior surface or superior border has a notch. Notch is named as suprascapular notch. There is a suprascapular ligament which turn it into suprascapular foramen, and the nerve suprascapular nerve goes under this ligament and above suprascapular vessel. Then it goes like to the infraglenoid nerve, that is spinoglenoid ligament may become the spinoglenoid notch, a bridge, and these vessels are goes down there. Okay, then come to the point of acromion process. This there is origin of deltoid muscle and the insertion of the trapezius muscle. The trapezius muscle insertion to the upper border of the crest of the spine on the along the medial border. This is the medial border and this long is lateral border. So lateral border gives origin of the deltoid muscle and trapezius muscle gives insertion into the medial border of the spinous process. Then acromion process already have I told that this is the lateral border, this is the medial border, and this is upper border. There is a crest. This crest for attachment of the clavicle. So acromioclavicular ligament present in the tip of the acromion. And this is coracoid process. This coracoid process is a bird tip like appearance, and there is this surface. This is superior surface, and also there is vertical and horizontal portion. The superior surface have which ligament? This coracoacromion ligament. Okay. And on the root there is coracohumeral ligament, which bones? Humerus clavicle. Then coracoclavicular ligament, where it formed the coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoclavicular ligament near the root, but on the superior extreme. All of this. Okay. So thank you so much. And JazakAllah Khair. Pray for us always. Is all about this class. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks to all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
বুঝতে পারতেছি সবাইকে রোজায় ধরছে, আমরাও রোজাদার, ঠিক আছে,
সবাই
রোজাদার করি, হ্যাঁ. Okay,
stay safe.